This is a dog. To be specific, my dog. He doesn't do much, but today, this little animal is going to think of a genius South Park script that will fit right in with anything else. Then I'm going to turn it into an actual South Park episode. Like any good writer, he won't be paid. But I promise you, he isn't a slave. Let's just call him an unknowing volunteer. He will be given three different choices for each part of the story, and he will choose by walking up and eating the correlating treat. All of it will be up to him, apart from this part. This is a canon event. I know I said that I wouldn't be paying him, but if you subscribe, I will give him a meal. That makes it sound like if you don't subscribe, he won't be fed, and that is 100% true, so you better do it. I realize having my dog eat from a bowl that is labeled poison isn't the best look, but just trust me, it is part of the story. Now that he has chosen his script, it is time to get to work on animation. I want this to actually look like the show, which means animating in 2D. There are so many different softwares I could use. Critter, Adobe, Blender, Flipperclip. Wait, Blender? Yeah, it turns out Blender has a 2D animation feature. Am I the only person who never knew that? I gave it a try, but it was kinda trash. But I still do like the idea of using Blender to make this. So I devised a 4-step plan. First, draw the models of the characters in Critter and then export them. Second, import them into Blender, then make a set, and then finally, animate it as if it was 2D. So, I've got to make these characters in some way. I imported the official models into Critter, which I could then trace over and basically just steal. But I did use a different layer for each part of their body so that I can move them all independently. Making Cartman took about 1.5 hours, because I am doing this all with a mouse. I am not using a mouse pad in this clip because it was being washed. I promise I'm not a psycho. But just using a mouse isn't good enough. What do I look like? A f***ing peasant? Now that I can draw like a normal person, the next character only took 45 minutes. A big improvement. Chef is my second favourite South Park character, right behind our lord and saviour, Eric Cartman. He has always been missing from my videos, which just seems wrong, but I finally have a reason to make him. Chef is always so good at giving advice to the boys, he never says anything wrong at all. Speaking of which, here is some advice that he has for you.
Hey viewers, how are you all today?
Bad.
Well, the only way to solve that is by subscribing to the MPT channel, of course. Do it, or else I will come over there and whoop all your asses.
As I said, Chef would never do anything wrong, so just do whatever he says. As we all know, Family Guy is written by manatees, and this is being written by a dog. And according to Google, manatees are definitely smarter than dogs, so don't have high hopes for the end of this video. Also, apparently the average IQ of a dog is 100, which is one higher than the 99 of Brexitland. Interesting. The next step was to get these characters into Blender. I didn't do much research, so I thought I could just import them as reference images and go from there. But turns out they wouldn't show up in renders. That is kind of the whole point of them, but I just forgot. So instead, I had to use planes and then set each element as a separate texture. But then you get all of this excess material. So to solve that, you do a bit of nodes work, and finally I had my characters in Blender, ready to be put into a scene. So that I could easily select the correct body parts, I grouped all of the characters into their own sections, so that if I wanted to move the whole body, I could just select it all and then go from there. My dog chose to visit the school cafeteria for this episode, so that is what I will be making. But actually, it is time for a quick side quest. Earlier, you heard Chef speaking. Whilst I wish that was an excerpt from the show, it had to be custom made. I unfortunately do not have access to the talent of Isaac Hayes, may he rest in peace, which means I have to enlist the soulless vocal cords of artificial intelligence. To train an AI, I use as much reference as I can. Cut out all of the lines by Chef and then feed them back into the generator. The last two lines were actually read by an AI of me. Pretty cool. This usually works pretty well, but when I went to record Cartman's lines, it sounded like he had been taken over by a demon.
Oh god damn it. Now I've gotta give him his $2!
Anyone who tries to tell you that AI isn't evil is factually wrong, and that was my proof. Now that the side mission has been completed, we can go back to the set. As I mentioned, this will all be taking place in the school cafeteria, an iconic location that has evaded me so far. I considered doing this as a 2D background by following the same process as making the characters, but I realized I could take advantage of Blender's 3D nature and just make it all out of 3D meshes. Let's do a quick rundown of what I made. Wall, 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 floor, table, table, another table, vending machine, notice board, a second notice board, and that is all I needed for the scene. Oh, also this bottle of poison, which I added a nice glass texture to, but we can ignore that for now. This is what the original looks like, and then this is what mine ended up looking like. Honestly, pretty close. Usually, I take creative liberty with how the characters are animated, but seeing as these are basically the exact same models as in the show, it makes sense for them to move in the same way as the original. If you didn't know, South Park was originally animated in stop motion. When they made the transition into digital, they wanted to keep the same jitter, which you see throughout all 26 seasons. This is not a style that lends itself to Blender though, because Blender likes to add in-between frames to help create fluidity, which means you end up having to use a lot of null frames that don't actually do anything other than tell the software when to start and stop an action. A new thing that I had not experimented with before is swapping out the character models as I am animating. I made angry versions of the faces, as well as a dead one for Kenny, which I could then have as separate objects and then just use them to replace the normal counterparts when they needed to. Looking back at the shot with Angry Cartman, it does look like he is doing a certain salute. If I just add this mustache, it becomes a very different story. The animation was finished, and it was time to render, but the render result looked something like this. Because of all the object intersections, they were rendered with black spots around the frame. At first, I thought there wasn't a way to resolve this, and I thought I had just wasted 3 days of my life and I'd have to start all over again. Until I realized that if I used an HDRI, I could circumnavigate the problem. The issue was that the lights were being affected by the invisible parts of the objects, but an HDRI will just evenly light everything no matter what. Then, I did that whole process all over again for the second scene, which I haven't even talked about yet. I really like this shot from the second scene. I don't know why, but it's just satisfying. How do you turn something like this into something that looks like the actual show? The first thing was a bit of color correction to make the colors of the faces pop out a bit more, and then a few small effects just for fun, and it was done. Wait, no it wasn't. I still had to do what I think may be considered the closest legal thing to torture in the UK, animating their mouths. The first thing to do is sync up all of the different mouth shapes to the audio. This takes a long time. Using mouth assets with tongues makes it look like they are angry, which was very helpful for this episode. Then, after the mouths look like they are talking, I need to make them follow the characters' mouths. This also takes a long time. After all of that, it is time for my dog's very own South Park episode. I hope you enjoy.
What's going on, guys?
I was just betting Kenny that he wouldn't drink this poison.
Oh my god, you killed Kenny.
Oh goddammit, now I've gotta give him his $2.
What the hell, dude? He's dead.
Chef, what should we do?
Now, children, there is only one thing to do in this situation.
What is it, Chef?
Put a firework up his asshole and send him into space, of course.